I was recently at Universal Studios in Los Angeles, and the most common theme between all of the rides there was exactly that. They are moving rides where actually what you are presented with is a certain amount of movement and themed environment, Harry Potter, The Simpsons, Transformers, etc. But what you have in front of you effectively is an immersive screen, and it is immersive enough that that your brain is able to completely suspend its disbelief, as it were, because you can feel movement and you can see stuff going on around you. And The Simpsons ride, I'd be interested to see how much we actually physically moved, but my guess is it was probably no more than a few feet and maybe 25 or 30 degrees in any direction.
Yeah.
But in the sections where you feel like you are shown that you are plunging off a roller coaster, my stomach lifted.
I do fear a bit that some of these early things actually are off-putting to people. Not a great experience, like Google Cardboard and a roller coaster app. If that's somebody's entry into 360 VR, is that going to persuade them to go, oh, this is something I want to consume more?
I mean, I think it's the obvious, creatively, it's the obvious go-to, in as much as, okay, it's VR, it's not the real world, it's the digital version of, so it's kind of reality light, but it's a great way of addressing people's need for wish fulfillment to create a digital proxy to events they otherwise might not be able to experience.
Well, it's the quickest way, to your point before, it's the quickest way to that adrenaline point, right? It's like, how do you grab somebody and throw them into this as quickly as possible? Oh, look, I'm on a roller coaster, it's going up and down, and I've tricked your body into feeling that this is really happening, right?
Yes.
But that does, it does lessen, and actually the execution of some of them isn't great.
Mm-hmm.
But when you think about kind of, I don't know, what comes next, and as consumers start to produce this stuff, I think, for me, there'll be quick wins in professional filmmaking will be animated. Imagine a Toy Story, right? In a 3D.
Well, you become one of the toys.
Yeah, exactly.
Like your silent toy in the game.
Exactly. Yeah. That, to me, will work very, very well and would be something that is very compelling. And actually, Facebook, one of the studios, I think it's called the Oculus Studio, is producing exactly that. Us doing this in this environment, I think that works quite well.
Well, we'll see.
You, the viewer, can decide.
You be the judge.
But yeah, it at least in theory, works quite well, right? Dragging somebody else into an environment and going, hey, we're going to wrap you in the midst of this and
join the conversation.
And join the conversation, exactly.
It's an interesting lead in to some of the concepts that may not be so obvious that could work well. I'm sure there's a better way to form that sentence. The idea of the estate agency, the walk around, the internal pictures, that's probably a relatively obvious one. You know, dropping a camera down inside a nuclear reactor that's malfunctioning and being able to actually just take the shot and then look all around after the event.
Health and safety. Chernobyl or something.
Correct, there's another one. I think there's something that's potentially very compelling that's very similar to this, actually, that is around video conferencing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, one of the problems with video conferencing, in my view, is, you know, even once you get over all the connectivity and audio and is my mic working and
at the end of the day.
Exactly. is you don't really feel part of it. You feel like you're on the outside and you're looking in, or you feel like there's somebody on a window, on a window up here, and they're kind of somewhere else and they're not really part of the meeting. If this was you at the other end, it'll be interesting to see when we see this. Does the viewer feel more like they are involved in this conversation? They probably wish they weren't, but do they feel like they're more involved in this conversation?